Dear friends, welcome to this edition of e-learning neuroanatomy. It's a new series, and this particular series is called Coronoradiator 2020. There's a particular reason for using this terminology, Coronoradiator 2020. The reason is, right now, the pandemic caused by this virus is going on across the world, and our country is also going through this. Classes have been suspended for students, and we, the faculty, are trying to manage at least some amount of classes through the e-learning mode or the digital mode. Therefore, I have labeled this neuroanatomy series as Coronoradiator 2020. Happy viewing. The topic for today's discussion is spinal cord, part 1. We'll call it first slice. It's a orientation for the next video, which will be more on histology of the spinal cord. To drive the next video, let us examine the spinal cord, some amount of gross features, not fine details, some introductory gross features, just enough to get a proper orientation of the spinal cord, so that the subsequent histological details on a cross section will be more meaningfully understood. That's the only objective of this particular video. Therefore, it's going to be a short but a very interesting video. Let's start. The spinal cord is the caudal component of the central nervous system, extending from the foramen magnum to L1 vertebral level. It's located inside the vertebral canal. Having said that, I am always fond of comparing the spinal cord to a coconut tree or maybe a palm tree, because it gives you a good comparison. And if we look at the brain and the spinal cord together, this is the anterior view. I repeat, this is the anterior view. The four arrows are pointing to the spinal cord, the upper part, larger part, the rest of the neuroanatomy. That's the brain details. We will skip that in this discussion particularly. The same specimen, posterior view, is shown. At this level of clarity, this is how you cannot make out much of a difference, but you will need to zoom in more into details for a further understanding. Nevertheless, let's isolate the spinal cord, and then let us see some important, very, very preliminary features of this particular structure. This part, there are only two items I am taking up: the spinal cord proper and the nerves that are emerging from it, the spinal nerves. So we have identified the spinal cord proper and the spinal nerve. Next, this looks like this particular plant called the desert palm, also known as the Washingtonia filifera. The spinous projections resemble the spinal nerves, and the central green part resembles the spinal cord. It is just a passing comparison. But when you do this, chop, chop, chop of the spinal cord. We are going to see this cord in cross section. Well, that's the cucumber in cross section, but then keeping that in mind, this is how the spinal cord cross section looks like. I have put a dotted line, a blinking dotted line, just a rough location here of the cross section. Next, the circular flashing arrow, circular flashing area, not arrow, I'm sorry, in blue and white dotted lines, brings you in focus with what exactly you will see in a cross section. Now we will enlarge it. We'll adjust the brightness and the contrast so that the visibility, the clarity improves. And first impressions, there are some brown patches and white patches. Nothing is really clear, but then if I draw your attention to probably something like this, two lines somewhere in the middle or below the middle, that's an area occupied by some white color. If I extend that whiteness and try to trace it into a more meaningful pattern, I'm sure you will appreciate this. Let's examine that in detail. Now that is one half, and that is the second half. Let's go back and create an H-shaped pattern within the sectioned spinal cord. Now there are two components. What is actually seen here in a relative whitish or ivory white, ivory yellow color is actually technically called the gray matter, and the rest of the area which is a little darker is actually the white matter. That means we have a H-shaped area in the center, central gray matter, surrounded by white matter. Basically, in the histology, we are going to take it up in fine detail. You will be introduced to the concepts that the gray matter is full of neurons and the white matter is full of bundles, nerve fibers. So hence this great contrast. Now, let's examine another photograph and let's see whether, you know, it's always better to the extent possible to see two, three photographs or specimens. Here the contrast and the brightness is slightly different, and let's see if we can make a better interpretation in this section. I put the same H here also, and I'm sure now the contrast is better. You can see the white matter versus the gray matter in better contrast. I have reduced the highlighting. And then, just to bring to a conclusion right in the middle, I have added a central canal. It's not very clearly seen in this specimen, but I have symbolically added a central canal. Now, that was a brief introduction to the spinal cord. Basically, the orientation of the spinal cord. There are so many other topics to be covered, but keeping in mind the stated objective is to give you a preview orientation for the next forthcoming histology lecture. We have covered a few important points. This was a presentation from the anatomy department, St. John's Medical College, Bangalore, India.